Hi, my name is Lyra Scout, and this is a brief WikiVids video about Antoine Lavoisier. Antoine Laurent de Lavoisier, August 26, 1743 to May 8, 1794, was a French nobleman and chemist central to the 18th century chemical revolution who had a large influence on both the history of chemistry and the history of biology. He is widely considered in popular literature to be the father of modern chemistry. It is generally accepted that Lavoisier's great accomplishments in chemistry largely stem from his changing chemistry from a qualitative to a quantitative science. Lavoisier is most noted for his discovery of the role oxygen plays in combustion. He isolated and named both oxygen, 1778, and hydrogen, 1783, and strongly opposed the phlogiston theory. Lavoisier helped construct the metric system, wrote the first extensive list of elements, and helped to reform chemical nomenclature. He predicted the existence of silicon, 1787, and was also the first to establish that sulfur was an element, 1777, rather than a compound. He discovered that although matter may change its form or shape, its mass always remains the same. Lavoisier was a powerful member of a number of aristocratic councils, as well as an administrator of the Ferme Générale. The Ferme Générale was one of the most hated components of the Ancien regime because of the profits it took at the expense of the state, the secrecy of the terms of its contracts, and the violence of its armed agents. All of these political and economic activities enabled Lavoisier to fund his scientific research. As the French Revolution gained momentum, attacks mounted on the deeply unpopular Ferme Générale, and it was eventually abolished in March 1791. In 1792, Lavoisier was forced to resign from his post on the Gunpowder Commission and to move from his house and laboratory at the Royal Arsenal. On August 8, 1793, all learned societies, including the Academy of Sciences, were suppressed at the request of Abbé Grégoire. On November 24, 1793, the arrest of all the former tax farmers was ordered. Lavoisier and the other farmers general faced accusations of defrauding the state of money, and of adding water to tobacco before selling it. Lavoisier drafted their defense, refuting the financial accusations and reminding the court of how they had maintained a consistently high quality of tobacco. The court, however, believed that by condemning them and seizing their goods, it would recover huge sums for the state. Lavoisier was convicted with summary justice of having plundered the people and the treasury of France, of having adulterated the nation's tobacco with water, and of having supplied the enemies of France with huge sums of money from the national treasury. He was guillotined on May 8, 1794 in Paris, at the age of 50, along with his 27 co-defendants. Lavoisier's importance to science was expressed by Lagrange, who lamented the beheading by saying, "Il n'y aura plus qu'un moment pour faire tomber cette tête, et cent années pour éternuer ce fier pas pour en reproduire un semblable." It took them only an instant to cut off this head, and 100 years might not suffice to reproduce its like. A year and a half after his death, Lavoisier was exonerated by the French government. His private belongings were delivered to his widow with a brief note that read to the widow of Lavoisier, who was falsely convicted. Well, my friends, I hope you've enjoyed this brief video about Antoine Lavoisier. Until next time, this has been Lyra Scout for WikiVids.